Hey YouTube, today we're going to be putting on our heated handlebar warmers for the Troy-Bilt Storm 2620. First thing we got to do is we're going to have to remove these handle grips that we have on right now, which are kind of like a polyfoam kind of thing. So I'm going to take those off. Yeah, make a nice slice right down there. I'm not touching the metal because I don't want to scratch it and start rusting. There. Let's see if I can't get this off. There we go. Let's pull that apart. There we go. There's one. And should be able to just tear that open. There we go. Voila. Nice powder coated handlebar. There's a screw hole here, there's another one underneath, obviously same thing over here, screw hole. We're going to be putting in self-tapping screws. Now the instructions say, when you put these on, that the wire should actually go on the outside, this side, and these slide right on. They're very loose, real loose, so that's why you're going to have to put those screws in. Put it on screw. There we go. So now I'm up underneath the dashboard, if you will, the panel here on the snowblower. Here's my headlight right up in here. And what it's telling me to do is to disconnect these wires. There's two, and I'm just going to unplug this one here and unplug the second one there. And what happens is, this goes down, trails down, and it comes around and connects right here by the starter. And so then splits off to a ground connection down here. And what we're going to do is we're going to undo this ground, take this wire off, take off this, disconnect this, and unravel this. Why? Because our kit includes all of this. It should... Whoops, sorry. There you go. Went for a little ride on me. Alright, so I was way off on this nut here. 10 millimeter. So we're just going to take this off here. Just like so. And we can discard that. So I'm going to put my ground back on. That's going to go right on here. And this is the ground to the new harness. Just gonna get this on. Okay, that's snug. And as I hold this up, you'll see this was tucked in around the top. And I could leave it like that. And you may not be able to see that. So this was just hanging like that. I could free it up if I needed the room, but this looks like this is gonna go right on. So should be good there. Let's put this on. And we're going to walk this back up the handlebar to the headlight switch. Okay, now it's going to depend on this next step on what type of blower you have. You could have the new harness that came with the factory headlight on your snowblower. I did not. I had the regular, probably the old style. So I can actually skip over having to use the jumper, new jumper harness. So I was able just to go right to the engine block ground screw and then feed it up. And then now I can go right back up to my headlight. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my switch here, my on off switch. There's already a hole here. Press that in. There we go. It's nice. Is I'm going to grab the one connector to the right handlebar grip, and I'm going to connect that and travel over to this side. And there's another connector right here, and this is the left handlebar. Now what I'm looking at is this dangling wire here, this harness. I've got a fuse. I've got a yellow and a green. And I got a blue and a red. The blue and the red, they're going to go up here into my... They're going to go up here into my light switch. Or my heater switch. And so now all that leaves is the yellow and the green. This is going to go up here to the headlight. There we go. What I'm going to do here is there's a notch right there. I'm going to feed the wire right through here. And that's going to, as you can see, neatly, very neatly tie that wire right in like that. So we won't have any snagging issues and won't have to worry about that. And then we'll get these connected. We have about six or so. And we're going to get that nice and snug down. And what we're going to do is just get this securely fastened up here and out of the way. And then we'll be ready to test it. So all in all, my kit left me with this connector here, which I did not need. The new connector, as you can see, that's the new one. This is the jumper, if you have a newer type blower. And then this is the old headlight harness that comes in the new headlight harness. And I used four zip ties, which leaves me two left. All in all, how much was it? $47 on Amazon with free shipping. It's a nice look. I say we test it out. This has never been fired up. It's a first time start, so we'll see how that runs, how it works. We'll flip the switch, and let's take a temperature reading too. We got 51. And then here down at the muffler, it's 46.4 on the muffler. All right, we're plugged in. The throttle is on low. I'm gonna go in that, right?
impressive how quiet that is. That's wide open. And that is very quiet. Well, we're approaching 90 degrees. Oh, that's gonna feel so good. Stay tuned. We got our half inch by 6 inch by 5 foot steel plate. Nice, big, thick, heavy steel plate that's going right on top of that log splitter for the top flange. Got that for $35. I thought that was a pretty good deal for a nice piece of steel from a local steel company, but that will not be warping anytime soon. And then we're going to be taking off this beautiful old Tecumseh 5-horse engine, Snow King engine. What we're going to do is put that on the mini bike. So I want to thank you very much for watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Throw on one of these handlebar warm kits if you have one of these popular MTD snowblowers. Oh, it feels so good. Let it snow, baby. Let it snow. We'll see you in the next one.